Hello everyone, let us continue the topic we started, chapter 4th, Landscape of the Soul. Before reading ahead, let me tell you the main points that we studied in our previous lecture. Okay, students, the chapter begins with a wonderful old tale about a painter Wu Daoji from China who had been asked to paint to draw a painting for the king Zhuangzu to decorate a palace wall. Okay, and he made it craftily. Okay, after that, when he presented this before the emperor, the emperor appreciated its outer beauty. Okay, then he asked him that he should be allowed to show the way. Okay, and even he indicated towards the bottom of the mountain and told him that there is a spirit lived there. Okay, then the painter clapped his hands, apne haath ke taali bajayi, and then the entrance of the cave was opened and the painter entered it, and then no trace of his brush could be seen there on that canvas. Okay, clear? So this was the Chinese view. Even in another story, a painter agitated making a dragon's eyes because he had fear that the dragon would fly if he would made the eye of it on the canvas. Okay, in another story, in 15th century in Antwerp, a blacksmith called Quentin Mistis, he fell in love with a painter's daughter. Okay, clear? But his father denied him and even told him that he would not marry his daughter to a person of a low professional values. Okay, so this man entered his studio silently, secretly, and he painted a fly on his latest panel. Okay, and he made it using an illusionistic likeness, and even the painter tried to hit it away to fly it away, but later he realized that it was just a painting. Okay, so in the Chinese stories, the emperor commissions a painting and appreciates its outer appearance. Okay, appearance, but the artist reveals him the true meaning of his work. Okay, the emperor may rule over the territory. Okay, clear? वो अपने जितने जो area है उस पे rule कर सकता है. Okay, but only the writer knows, only the artist knows the way within. Okay, clear? And thou, let me show the way. And the Dao, a word that means both of the side, both of the aspect. Okay, and the mysteries, works of the universe. Okay, clear? The painting of Wu Daoji is gone, but the artist has reached his goal beyond any material appearances. Ki bhai, there are so many things that cannot be understood without anyone's help. Okay, so beta, ye kal humne yahan tak padha tha. Okay, so let us study it some more. Okay, a classical Chinese landscape is not meant to reproduce an actual view as would a Western figurative painting, whereas the European painter wants you to borrow his eyes and look at a particular landscape exactly as he saw it from a specific angle. Okay, so what we have come to know in figurative painting is that in a European painter, in European painting, a painter wants you to borrow his eyes. Means if you want to interpret the European painting, the art of European painting, okay, you have to borrow his eyes. Means you have to adopt the outlook the painter has used, okay, and you have to look at a particular landscape exactly as he saw, with a specific, from a specific angle. Okay, Chinese painter does not choose a single viewpoint, but Chinese art form is quite different from that of European form of art. Okay, here Chinese painter does not choose a single viewpoint. Okay, his landscape is not a real one. Okay, and you can enter it from any point. Uski jo landscape hai na, it was not real one, but we can enter it from any of the point, then travel in it. Fir hum travel karte hain usme. The artist creates a path for your eyes to travel up and down, then back again in a leisurely movement. Means one can easily walk across the painting and look at the things being painted or being exhibited there, being shown there in the painting. Okay, this is even more true in the case of horizontal scroll. Aur hum isi ko bolte hain ki ye kisi kisi prakar se horizontal scroll se bhi wo sahi bhi hai, matlab usse sahi hai. In which the action of slowly opening one section of painting, then rolling it up to move on to onto the other, adding a dimension of time which is unknown in any other form of painting. Okay, so means isko dekh kar bilkul aisa lagta hai jaise ki ek aap kisi cheez mein enter kar gaye, pravesh kar gaye, and thereafter aap matlab new lagta hai jaise ki ek horizontal paper ke andar koi cheez lipti padi ho. Okay, koi cheez लिपटी पड़ी हो, एंड इन विच एक्शन जो है वो स्लोली स्लोली धीरे धीरे उन एक्शंस को हम कर रहे हैं. एंड इट एवरी टाइम वेन एवर वी चेक इट, वी एड सम न्यू डायमेंशन, नया आयाम उसमें जोड़ देते हैं. और ऐसा अन्य किसी और प्रकार की जो पेंटिंग है ना उसमें देखने को नहीं मिलता है. ओके, सो ऑल वी वॉन्ट इज द पार्टिसिपेशन, एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ द व्यूअर. व्यूअर का एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन हमें इसमें चाहिए. It is also requires the active participation of the viewer who decides at what place he will travel. वो खुद decide करेगा, viewer का participant होगा कि where he will choose the way he will travel through the painting, कहाँ से जाएगा, कैसे जाएगा. A participation which is physical as well as mental, and this participation can be physical or as well as mental. Okay. The Chinese painter does not want you to borrow his eyes. He wants you to enter his mind. Means this is the basic difference. Here Chinese painter is not borrowing your eyes. He wants his viewer to enter his mind. Okay, to interpret the idea, basic idea that he has adopted there. Okay, the landscape is an inner one or a spiritual and conceptual स्पेस. ओके, कंसेप्चुअल स्पेस. सो ये तो है, ये जो लैंडस्केप है, जो पिक्चर ऑफ दैट लैंड है या भूदृश्य का जो इंटरनल जो है ना, ये इंटरनल भी है, स्पिरिचुअल भी है, एंड इट इज़ अ यू कैन से कंसेप्चुअल स्पेस. इट इज़ अ प्रोसेस दैट प्रोवोक्स योर थॉट्स, एंड मीन्स थॉट प्रोसेस का भी एक स्पेस है, मतलब वैचारिक क्षेत्र भी अपने आप में है. ओके, क्लियर. लेट्स हैव द इंग्लिश एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पैसेज वी हैव जस्ट गोन थ्रू. ओके, द चाइनीज लैंडस्केप पेंटिंग इज नॉट मेड अ रियल व्यू पॉइंट, बट इट इज अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द आर्टिस्ट्स थॉट. ओके, the Western painting in Europe is a figurative art form. Okay, art form The European painter paints a landscape to show you a specific scene of the landscape, where the Chinese painter does not choose a real viewpoint. Okay, you can enter the painting from any point and can travel anything, anywhere where your thoughts and imagination take you. Okay, the Chinese artist wants you to travel by creating your own paths and then come out in a relaxed moment. Okay, in China, the mode of seeing a painting is more enjoyable. A horizontal scroll is a form where one section of painting is opened one by one, rolling it up to move on the other side. It creates a dimension which is not practiced in any other form of artwork. Okay, it requires both mental and physical participation of the viewer. Okay, the Chinese painter wants you to enter his mind, okay, and see the painting from his thoughts. Okay, the landscape created by Chinese artist is spiritual, inner, and of conceptual and abstract or abstract space. Okay, means it is something that is beyond the concrete ideas. Okay, clear? Let us read the next paragraph. The concept is expressed as a sanshui, literally mountain water, which used together represent the word landscape. Okay, जो landscape है ना उसको represent करने के लिए here the concept has been used as the with the name sanshui. Okay, that means mountain water. Okay, clear? More than two elements of an image, these represent two complementary poles reflecting the Taoist views of the universe. The mountain is yang, reaching vertically towards heaven, and stable, warm and dry in the sun, while the water is yin, horizontal and resting in the resting on the earth, fluid, moist and cool. Okay, in Taoist view point, वो क्या कहता है कि he painted a landscape in which he had shown the water bodies, okay, the mountain, rivers, okay, the trees, okay, everything. So here he described the theory of old Chinese theory of yang and yin. Okay, here yang is masculine and yin is feminine. Okay, yang is vertically, okay, and the mountains represent yang, okay, and they stand vertically, heaven, towards heaven, stable, warm and dry, okay, in the sun, sukhe hain bilkul dhoop mein wo, and while the water is yin, dusra jo part hai wo kya hai, yin, jo ki that is horizontal and in a resting position on this earth, fluid, usme fluid hai, liquid hai, moist hai, and it is cool. The interaction of yin and the receptive, the feminine aspect of universal energy and its counterpart yang, active and masculine, is of course a fundamental notion of Taoism. Karaki, the yang and yin, both they meet at a place, okay, and jo yang hai, it's a masculine part, and yin is a feminine part. Okay, when the counterpart active and masculine is of course when it meets, okay, did some course with yin, okay, so this represents the course of fundamental concept of Taoism. Uska fundamental concept wo samjha raha hai. What is often overlooked is an essential third element. Lekin ek cheez aur bhi hai. Out of these two elements, yang and yin, there is another thing that is called the third element, that is the middle void, okay, where their interaction takes place. Means where yang and yin, they both meet, दैट प्लेस इज कॉल्ड मिडल मिडल वर्ल्ड, ओके, जहाँ पे वो इंटरेक्शन करते हैं. दिस कैन बी कंपेयर्ड विद द योगिक प्रैक्टिस ऑफ प्राणायाम, ब्रीदिंग इन, ब्रीद इन, रिटेन, ब्रीद आउट. द सस्पेंशन ऑफ ब्रीद इज द वर्ल्ड. वी कैन इवन कंपेयर इट विद द योगिक आसन दैट इज कॉल्ड प्राणायाम. इन प्राणायाम प्लेस वेयर दे मीट एंड दिस वाइट पार्ट इज कॉल्ड मिडल वर्ल्ड, ओके, एंड विदाउट दिस प्लेस, विदाउट दिस स्पेस नथिंग कैन बी हैपेंड. ओके क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट मी शो यू व्हाट यांग एंड यिन आर. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी इन दिस सर्कल व्हाइट पार्ट एंड ब्लैक ब्लैक वन. ओके क्लियर, लेट मी मेक यू क्लियर वन थिंग. दिस पार्ट इज कॉल्ड मिडिल वर्ल्ड. ओके क्लियर, हियर दिस पिक्चर रिप्रेजेंट्स अनदर थियरी रिलेटेड टू यिंग एंड यैंग. ओके क्लियर, यैंग इज द ब्राइटर साइड, ओके, एंड यिन इज द डार्कर साइड. ओके दिस इज यिन एंड दिस इज यैंग. ओके क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स, एंड दिस वाइट अनपेंटेड पार्ट इज कॉल्ड वी कैन से द मिडिल वर्ल्ड. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, द चाइनीज कंसेप्ट ऑफ आर्ट इज ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस्ड एज सेंचुरी, ओके, विच ऑल्सो मीन्स माउंटेन वाटर. ओके इट इज यूज टुगेदर टू रिप्रेजेंट द लैंडस्केप. ओके द टू कम्प्लीमेंट्री पोल्स ऑफ एन इमेज रिफ्लेक्ट द दाओइस्ट व्यू. ओके द माउंटेन इन द लैंडस्केप इज यांग विच मीन्स टू रीच वर्टिकली टुवर्ड्स हेवन, स्टेबल, वार्म एंड ड्राई इन द सन. ओके वेयर एज द वॉटर इज द यिन, ओके, विच इज रिसेप्टिव एंड फेमिनिन आस्पेक्ट ऑफ यूनिवर्सल एनर्जी. द यांग इज एन इज एक्टिव एंड मस्कुलिन एंड द अपोजिट ऑफ यिन. देर इज अ थर्ड असेंशियल एलिमेंट विच इज मिडिल वर्ल्ड विच इज द प्लेस वेयर दे इंटरेक्ट. दिस मिडिल वर्ल्ड कैन बी कंपेयर्ड टू प्राणायाम विच मीन्स टू ब्रीद इन, रिटेन एंड ब्रीद आउट. हियर द सस्पेंशन ऑफ ब्रीद इज द वर्ल्ड इन द मेडिटेशन प्रोसेस. ओके इट इज द असेंशियल पार्ट एज नथिंग कैन हैपन विदाउट इट. हैंस द वाइट अनपेंटेड स्पेस इन चाइनीज लैंडस्केप इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज ऑल्सो नेक्स्ट पैरा, दिस इज ऑल्सो वेयर मैन फाइंड्स अ फंडामेंटल रोल इन दैट स्पेस बिटवीन हेवन एंड अर्थ एंड ही बिकम्स द conduit of communism between both poles. Okay, both poles the of the universe. Clear, and both conduit of communication between both poles of the universe. His presence is essential, even if it is also suggested far from being lost or oppressed by the lofty peaks. He is in Francisco Chang's words expression, the eye of the landscape. Okay, conduit means channel or tube, oppressed means burdened, worried, lofty means tall, high, and you can say alluring. Okay, the middle void, let us read this English explanation of this special para. Okay, the English the middle void is where a man finds an important role. Okay, a man is the channel of communication in the space between the heaven and the earth. Okay, heaven and the earth, and these are which are the two poles of universe. Okay, man's presence is essential there. it is not being lost and suppressed due to high peaks he is the eye of the landscape. Okay, Francois Chang's ने इस चीज़ को बताया है. ओके बेटा, दिस इज़ द प्लेस, यही एक जगह है जहाँ पर जो मनुष्य है, मैन है, उसकी जो मेन रोल है वो शुरू होता है. आकाश, द हेवन एंड द अर्थ, इनके बीच का वह स्थान, ओके, जो कि दैट इज़ जो कि यूनिवर्स के दोनों पोल्स के संचार का माध्यम है, दोनों पोल्स के बीच में कम्युनिकेशन एस्टेब्लिश करता है. ओके और इसकी जो प्रेजेंस है ना, ये बहुत नेसेसरी है, क्योंकि दोनों का जो आवास मात्र है ना, वही उसी से उन ऊंची चोटियों के बीच गुम हो जाने और गुम होने या दबाए जाने से परे. तो फ्रैंकोइस जो चेंग है ना, उसकी अद्भुत अभिव्यक्ति ये है कि वो कहता है कि ये जो जगह है ना, ये है आई ऑफ द लैंडस्केप, ये लैंडस्केप की आँख के बराबर है. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, so this is what given in this chapter. Students, one more part, one more form of art is given in your notebook, sorry, in your textbook. So let us try and study that also. Okay, so you see this excerpt, this chapter is an excerpt from Landscape of Soul, Ethics and Spirituality in Chinese Painting, slightly edited. इसको थोड़ा सा एडिट किया गया है. Now, this is the book that I was talking about, Getting Inside Outsider Art. Outsider Art के अंदर जाना. When French painter Jean the Fifth mooted the concept of art brought in 1940s, the art of the untrained visionary was the minority interest, was of minority interest. 1940s में जब फ्रेंच पेंटर जीन डफेट ने पहली बार आर्ट ब्रट नाम के कॉन्सेप्ट को जब इंट्रोड्यूस किया था, तो इस आर्ट को लोग कहते थे आर्ट ऑफ द अनट्रेंड विजनरी. ओके, इसको मतलब अनट्रेंड लोगों का आर्ट इसको कहा जाता था. फ्रॉम its almost veiled beginnings, outsider art has gradually become the fastest growing area of interest in contemporary art internationally. But after this theory's publication, it became gradually the fastest growing area, means people find it a most interesting contemporary things or form of art internationally. Okay, and they started devoting their time and making such an or using such an art to decorate their world with it. Okay, clear. This genre is described as the art of those who have no right to be artists, as they have received no formal training yet show talents and artistic insight. Okay, clear. This type of art is quite for those who have no right to be called an artist. Okay, and those who haven't got formal training, informal training nahi na, unka ye ek wo hai type of art hai ye. Theek hai, their works are a stimulating contrast to a lot of mainstream offering. But if we see and check or visit their work, okay, they are quite stimulating, provoking, okay, and they represent a comparison to that of a lot of mainstream offerings. The mainstream jo artist hai na, unke barabar unse badhiya kaam in logon ne kar rakha hai. Around the time of the face was profounding his concept in India, an untutored genius was creating a paradise. Okay, when in 1940s, when Jean, the French artist, he was propounding his concept. Okay, जब अपने उसको concept को जो फैला रहा था, बात कर रहा था, he was just making research on it. Okay, an untutored genius,
एक नोवाइस जीनियस, एक एन एन अप्रेंटिस जीनियस, ही वॉज क्रिएटिंग हेवन ऑन दिस अर्थ. यर्स अगो अ लिटिल पैच ऑफ जंगल दैट ही बिगेन क्लियरिंग टू मेक हिमसेल्फ अ गार्डन स्कल्प्टेड विथ स्टोन एंड रिसाइकल मटीरियल इज नोन टू द वर्ल्ड एज द रॉक गार्डन एट चंडीगढ़. ओके, वैन द कंसेप्ट वॉज जस्ट बींग रिपाउंडिंग प्रोपाउंडिंग इन द वर्ल्ड. ओके, वन ऑफ द जीनियस इज देयर वॉज एन आर्टिस्ट हु वॉज ट्राइंग टू हु बिल्ट हु क्रिएटेड अ पैराडाइज ऑन अर्थ. ओके, दैट इज नाउ नोन एज रॉक गार्डन एट चंडीगढ़. ओके, ही क्लियर्ड पैच ऑफ जंगल, जंगल को थोड़ा साफ करके, एंड ही क्रिएटेड अ गार्डन इन विच ही स्कल्प्टेड सो मैनी स्कल्पचर्स. ओके, एंड अदर आइडल्स यूजिंग द वेस्ट मटीरियल. ओके, हियर यू माइट हैव सीन दीज थिंग्स, दीज स्कल्पचर मेड ऑफ ब्रोकन बैंगल्स इन द रॉक गार्डन बाई नेकचंद. ओके, क्लियर. वॉट अ ब्यूटिफुल प्लेस इट इज इफ यू सी इट. ओके, इट्स 80-year-old क्रिएटर डायरेक्टर नेकचंद इज नाउ हेल्ड एज इंडियाज बिगेस्ट कंट्रीब्यूटर टू आउटसाइडर आर्ट. और 80 साल बाद इसका जो क्रिएटर डायरेक्टर है ना, कौन, नेकचंद, ही वॉज वेलकम्ड एज इंडियाज बिगेस्ट कंट्रीब्यूटर टू द आउटसाइडर आर्ट. इस आउटसाइडर आर्ट के लिए बिगेस्ट कंट्रीब्यूशन के रूप में इसको कहा जाता है, कंट्रीब्यूटर के रूप में इसको माना जाता है. द 50th issues of spring 2005 of Raw Vision, a UK based magazine. This magazine ne kya kya pioneer in outsider publication, features Nekchand and his rock garden sculpture Woman by the Waterfall, and even in the edition of spring in 2005. Okay, Raw Vision, UK based magazine, It has published an article under the headline Women by the Waterfall on its anniversary issues cover page. Cover page के ऊपर Women by the Waterfall के नाम से उन्होंने एक cover page बनाया था उसका. That was a great achievement for this artist. Okay, the notion of art but and art raw art was the was works of that were in the raw state as regard cultural and artistic influences. Okay, anything and everything from a tin to a sink to a broken down car could be material for a work of art, something Nekchand has taken to dizzling heights. Okay, clear. Students, establishing or creating such a garden in Chandigarh, Nekchand has taught the world a lesson that anything to everything means whatever it is, a tin or whatsoever it is, a sink or pieces of broken down car and glass and all that, everything can be used or can be used to create a beautiful thing like that. Okay, and he was the person who has taken this art form to a dazzling height. Okay, recognizing his art as an outstanding testimony of the difference a single man can make when he lives his dream. Okay, and visiting his rock garden, one can easily produce a testimony or a document that it is a concrete proof of a single man can make. Means what difference can a single man make, okay, when he lives his dream. जब हम अपने सपनों को जीतते हैं ना, and we try to make them come true, okay, clear, we can even create such a wonderful thing in the world. Okay, clear. The Swiss commission for UNESCO will be honoring him by way of European exposition of his works. Okay, शायद उसको यूनेस्को भी, उसको स्विस कमीशन जो यूनेस्को का है ना, वो भी उसको ऑनर कर रहा होगा. द 5 मंथ्स इंटरेक्टिव शो रियलम ऑफ नेकचंद बिगिनिंग अक्टूबर विल बी हेल्ड एट लीडिंग म्यूजियम इन स्विट्जरलैंड, बेल्जियम, फ्रांस एंड इटली. तो शायद ये इनमें मदद करेंगे इनकी म्यूजियम्स वगैरह बनाने में इन सब देशों के. ओके, द बिगेस्ट रिवॉर्ड इज वॉकिंग थ्रू द गार्डन एंड सीइंग पीपल इन्जॉय माई क्रिएशन. नेकचंद से फॉर नेकचंद वॉचिंग पीपल विजिटिंग एंड अप्रिशिएटिंग इज क्रिएशन द रॉक गार्डन इन चंडीगढ़ वॉज द रियल अवार्ड फॉर हिम. ओके, एंड ही रियली अप्रिशिएट इट, ही रियली अप्रिशिएट अप्रिशिएट्स द पीपल पीपल्स अटमोस्ट इंटरेस्ट एंड इन्जॉय वेन दे विजिट देयर विजिट हिज गार्डन, रॉक गार्डन. ओके, सो दिस आर्टिकल वॉज पब्लिश्ड ऑन 28th August 2005 इन हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स. ओके क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? स्टूडेंट्स लेट मी शो यू सम ऑफ द इमेजेस ऑफ रॉक गार्डन. ओके, बिफोर एंडिंग दिस लेक्चर. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज एन इमेज ऑफ रॉक गार्डन वेयर यू कैन सी दीज स्कल्पचर्स, idols. All these idols are made of the waste material. Okay, clear? See one more. Okay, these are the women idol. Okay, clear? Another. Okay, and this was the fountain. Okay, that's why the American journal or the magazine published it this page along with these one women by the waterfall. Okay, clear? Each and everything that you have seen here, okay, is made of the waste material that we sometimes throw. Okay, so nothing in this world is waste. Okay, clear? We can even use them in a better way. Okay students, clear? So this is all about the chapter Landscape of the Soul. Okay. I'll send you a PDF, okay, comprising the questions and answer of this chapter. Okay, clear? Do note them in your fair notebooks. Okay, keep studying beta. Okay, and stay home, be safe. Thanks for watching this video.